We'll also discuss our deep concerns with actions by China, including in Xinjiang, Hong Kong, Taiwan, cyber attacks on the United States, economic coercion toward our allies. Each of these actions threaten the rules-based order that maintains global stability. That's why they're not merely internal matters and why we feel an obligation to raise these issues here today. I said that the United States relationship with China will be competitive where it should be, collaborative where it can be, adversarial where it must be.
We do not seek conflict, but we welcome stiff competition, and we will always stand up for our principles, for our people, and for our friends.
我们所遵循的国际社会所遵循的是以联合国为核心的国际体系，是以国际法为基础的国际秩序，而不是一小部分国家所鼓吹的以规则为基础的国际秩序。我们中国 是挺得过来的，所以我们对中美关系的评价，也就是习近平主席讲的，就是要不冲突、不对抗、相互尊重、合作共赢。不冲突、不对抗，也是拜登总统自己通过电话 跟习主席讲的，所以我们在这个时期应该全面的、正确的贯彻两国领导人的共识，使得中美关系能够重新回到健康稳定发展的轨道上来。谢谢。
When I came into office, you may recall, I set a goal that many of you said was a kind of Tonight, I'm announcing that I will direct all states, tribes, and territories to make all adults, people 18 and over, eligible to be vaccinated no later than May 1. Let me say that again. All adult Americans will be eligible to get a vaccine no later than May 1. That's much earlier than expected. Let me be clear. That doesn't mean everyone's going to have that shot immediately, but it means you'll be able to get in line beginning May 1. Every adult will be eligible to get their shot. And to do this, we're going to go from 1 million shots a day that I promised in December, before I was sworn in, to maintaining, beating our current pace of 2 million shots a day, outpacing the rest of the world. I promise I will do everything in my power. I will not relent until we beat this virus. But I need you, the American people. I need you. I need every American to do their part. And that's not hyperbole. I need you. I need you to get vaccinated when it's your turn and when you can find an opportunity. And to help your family, your friends, your neighbors get vaccinated as well. Because here's the point. If we do all this, if we do our part, if we do this together, by July the 4th, there's a good chance you, your families and friends will be able to get together in your backyard or in your neighborhood and have a cookout or a barbecue and celebrate Independence Day. That doesn't mean large events with lots of people together, but it does mean small groups will be able to get together. After this long, hard year, that will make this Independence Day something truly special, where we not only mark our independence as a nation, but we begin to mark our independence from this virus.